Topic: The Queen of Dark, Nyakim Gotwek. We see people in the spotlight getting bullied and very heavily judged every day. Sometimes the internet hate gets so bizarre that the haters behind their computer screens get celebrities and models to change themselves forcibly by making them feel uncomfortable with how they are. But there's one model who wore her societal flaw so confidently that now she's known for it. Meet Nyakim Gotwek, world's darkest-skinned person who showed the world just how amazing and normal it can be to be unique without thinking of it as a problem. Wait, before we go on with our video, why don't you take some time to subscribe to our channel? Make sure that you also hit the bell icon so that you can be notified every time we upload a new video. Now, let's get going. Early life. Today's Queen of the Dark, Nyakim Gotwek, was born in Gambela in Ethiopia to a couple who fled from South Sudan during the Civil War to Gambela, where she was born. Not too long after which, the family moved to Kenya. For a long time, they lived in refugee camps. We all know refugee camps are no good for anyone, and no one ever chooses to move to one. Life was hard for them, but once Nyakim turned 14, they finally migrated to Buffalo, New York in the USA. Although, when Nyakim was old enough to be independent, she moved to Minneapolis in Minnesota. She is the one that carries her parents' hometown in her hair. She states that although she has been to South Sudan herself, but she still doesn't hesitate to consider herself South Sudanese. Being bullied into feeling insecure. Although Gotwek was excited to begin her new school in America, but that excitement very quickly vanished when she started facing problems fitting in her new school. It wasn't just a language barrier for her, it was also the constant pinpointing at bad remarks on her skin color. Comments like, "Go shower," or "Get the dirt off your skin," made her feel like her deeply pigmented skin was different or bad. She constantly felt like she had to somehow take her skin off because other kids referred to it as dirty. She expressed how hurt she would feel when she walked up to kids from her English class in the cafeteria and they would just simply walk away. Struggling with fitting in. Because of how much Nyakim had to move constantly with her family as refugees and adjusting to new cultures was challenging for her. In an interview with CBS News, she talked about how, at first, she was okay with her self-esteem. But once she was started being judged, criticized, and torn down by her society, she felt her self-esteem drop. The judgments made her question herself. She started asking herself questions like, "Do I blend in with what society considered to be beautiful?" Recognizing her love for modeling. Nyakim expresses how the thought of modeling would haunt her because of being told constantly that she was not beautiful. "I thought models are beautiful with light skin and long hair," said Nyakim Gotwek. However, in high school, Nyakim participated in a local fashion show which sparked her interest in modeling. She thought of giving it a shot just because how much she loved being on stage. Just a week after her first walk for a local show, she did her first shoot with a local photographer. Her first thought after the photo shoot was that she wanted to prove those people wrong, and she wanted her bullies to see her star on magazine covers and think, "Oh, she's that girl from middle school." Facing problems when pursued modeling. Nyakim continued to pursue a career in modeling, and it helped her gain confidence as well. She always felt that the modeling industry was biased towards fair skin, and it had been for a long time. But because of her, that started to change. When she started off modeling, at the very beginning, she would see an image of her skin looking much lighter than what she already was and think, "Is this what they want me to look like? Will they not accept me for being darker?" Even though she started pursuing the career she had always wanted for herself. But she still faced problems, being rejected because the agency wouldn't like her skin pigment, being asked to come makeup ready but makeup artists were not skilled enough to do makeup on skin like hers, being asked to bring her own foundation because of how dark her skin tone was. Even now, she says that makeup brands do not make foundations and makeup for her skin tone, so she used to use black eyeshadow in order to contour her face. Her success. Now, Nyakim has come a long way. Who knew the little girl who used to live with her parents in refugee camps, the little girl who used to be bullied, and the one who was constantly made to feel ashamed of her skin color would grow up to be a fashion icon? Every now and then, Nyakim is hired by famous luxury brands and magazines like Zara, L'Oreal, WOE Magazine, Calvin Klein, and Urban Skin to feature and represent their brands on billboards and TVs, and also on social media platforms. The stigma of colorism has negatively impacted the self-esteem of many young black girls and women. For one model, her dark skin helped her give birth to a thriving modeling career worth $9 million. The Queen of Dark, Nyakam Gotwek's real success is not her wealth or her net worth or her recognition. Her real success is her acceptance of her own skin tone. It took this Sudanese model years and years to just tell herself that her skin was perfect, that she was beautiful and not less than anyone else. Her classmates' remarks would haunt her when she wanted to start her career, but she didn't let those thoughts and ugly comments stop her. And that's her biggest achievement. Although now she has a beautiful family with her husband and has a son, but one thing that she will pass on to her kids might not be her color or her struggle, but it would be her confidence and the way she looks at life. By using herself as an example, she made a million other insecure girls who were afraid of loving themselves confident. We need more people like Nyakam, who not only live their own life, but also make living easy for millions of other people around the world. Have you ever felt like Nyakam and felt left out? How do you handle situations where you feel judged and criticized? Let us know in the comments below. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content. Also, hit the bell icon button so that you'll get a notification whenever we post a new video. Your engagements really help us grow and reach to more audiences that's just as amazing as you. See you in our next video. Till then, goodbye.